During a speech at CPAC over the weekend, former President Donald Trump downplayed any concerns about climate change because, you know, of course, and said that it actually is a good thing because more seafront property. Take a look.
I saw John Kerry on television, and we're talking about energy. We need energy. We need oil. We need gas. We need everything. No, no, no. No, no, global warming, global warming. We have a world that's ready to blow up and disintegrate over energy, and he's talking about global warming. The oceans may rise over the next 300 years, 1/100th of an inch. Giving you slightly more seafront property. And this is his problem. He's not thinking about the nuclear warming. He's thinking about other types of warming. These people are not living in a world of reality.
That's probably the most ironic statement I've ever heard from Donald Trump. Oh, you know, they're just not living in a reality, in real world. I don't understand. We just had Donald Trump, who can't stop talking about how the election was rigged despite having zero evidence, is talking about people not living in the real world. That's hilarious. That's chef's kiss. Perfect. Perfect. Now the reality, of course, is that climate change is a pretty big issue. It is actually an existential issue facing not just the United States, but every human being on the planet. And of course, that's not to minimize, of course, what's going on with the tensions with Russia and the fact that, you know, we have two countries that have gigantic stockpiles and arsenals of nuclear weapons that could destroy the world. And of course, he did address that as the nuclear warming. But let's go to, before we talk about that, let's talk about climate change. Let's talk about sea level rise, you see. Now, sea levels along the United States coastlines actually will not rise by 1/1000th of an inch? No, by 2050, it is estimated that it could rise as much as 1 foot. 1 foot. That's according to a new report led by the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. Scientists also anticipate that water could rise by the end of the century a total of 2 feet. No, great. Great. Think about this, okay? That's a lot of water. Think about your city. Think about it, you know, your roads, your house, right? A foot of water on the road. Now, of course, we're not looking at like Kevin Costner, Waterworld, drinking your own pee, which of course QAnoners are doing anyway, without it having to be the water apocalypse. There's no like skyscrapers that are underwater. But just a foot of water. Understand that you can't live there. You can't. I mean, can you drive in that? Not very well. Can you walk to work in that? Bring your galoshes. Better be, hell yeah, you might as well wear an entire water suit, or at least your pants. How are you gonna work in that? You gonna have a restaurant where, what? You gonna have restaurants on stilts now? All the things that you would do in a city with a foot of water, you can't really do. You can't really do. You can't play golf. Can't play golf in the water. No, you'd have to abandon the city and move to higher ground or somehow move the city up. Again, you can't really do anything, okay? And by the way, I love this because this is what conservatives think about this. Remember when Ben Shapiro was like, sea level rises and not really a big problem. I mean, you can just sell your house and move somewhere else. Who are you going to sell your house to, Ben? Fucking Aquaman? Seriously? That's their plan. That's their plan. Just sell your water to who? Who? No, this is going to be economically devastating. Jesus Christ. And by the way, by 2050, it's estimated that these cities could be partly underwater. if we do absolutely nothing. Amsterdam in the Netherlands, Basra, Iraq, New Orleans in the USA, Venice of Italy, Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam, Kolkata, India, Bangkok, Thailand, Georgetown, Guyana, and Savannah, Georgia. So these places are low enough to where a foot of water would be devastating, partly submerged. And by the way, again, if it's a foot or 6 inches, 3 inches, guess what? That makes a big difference in the long run. Because what you're going to have is a mass migration to higher areas, a loss of land, property values. Imagine what happens when you lose part of the coastline. Now, most people live on the coastline in the United States, okay? And so what's that gonna do about property values? Now, of course, people that do real estate, I guess Donald Trump's like, yeah, let's do this. Yeah, I'm gonna cash in on all the people trying to run to higher ground. Well, that's gonna price out poor people, but again, Donald Trump, Republicans don't really give a shit. The large real estate companies, they're expecting a massive windfall. Isn't that amazing how capitalism basically ruins everything? But all right, so there's gonna be gigantic disruption now. That's the problem. And that's the reality of what's going to happen if we do not curb the usage of fossil fuels, if we do absolutely nothing. And by the way, I mean, he mentioned, we've got an energy crisis, whatever. We wouldn't have that energy crisis if we didn't have these constant conflicts over what? Oil, natural gas, these fossil fuels. So wouldn't it make sense then to transition away from the fossil fuels, which eventually run out, and go to renewable energy? And by the way, yes, I do think nuclear energy will help. I know that's not a popular position among lefties, or at least among liberals. But look, this is something that we can use. We have the technology already in order to get us off fossil fuels, which are far more dangerous. And this is as we develop cleaner, safer technologies along with solar, wind, geothermal, the stuff that we already have, et cetera, et cetera. And so, look, speaking of nuclear, by the way, you might have noticed that Donald Trump is such a raging dipshit that he had talked about something called nuclear warming. Remember, the nuclear warming. Oh, it's not global warming. There's going to be the nuclear warming. It's warming from the standpoint of nuclear. Oh, my God. If, and I stress if, that there is a devastating nuclear exchange, which, again, would be just a tragedy of untold human proportions. And I can't believe we're even having this conversation or entertaining this. But, yes, if that happens, the explosion would kill millions of people. And then, of course, you would have radiation, you would have fallout. Oh, and by the way, you would have dust and debris and all of that stuff getting kicked up into the atmosphere, which would block out the sun. And you know what that would have? What that would create? A nuclear winter, not a nuclear summer, but a winter, which would be the opposite of nuclear warming. Now, I'm not going to discount the idea of this nightmare scenario. Yes, Russia has nukes. The United States has a ton of nukes. More so, by the way, thanks to Donald Trump, who increased the amount of nuclear weapons that we have. But at the same time, we ought to be very, very concerned about climate change. And really, both of them are man-made issues that we could prevent with good policy and smart thinking, which, as I will mention again, Donald Trump does not possess the ability to do.